next guest has turned his amazing weight loss into, well, a big fat joke. He's the hilarious breakout star from the new weight loss reality show, Too Large. And get this, he weighed in at roughly 300 kilos before the show and has managed to shed a staggering 125 kilos thanks to life-changing weight loss surgery, a new diet and fitness regime.
Yeah, but let me tell you, his backstory is even more jaw-dropping than his weight loss.
My name's Corey. I'm 28. I'm gay. I'm definitely a thick bitch with a few extra C's. I currently live with my best friend Renee in Cartersville, Georgia. We share a one-bedroom apartment. Her bedroom is the living room as a way to stretch a penny, and we're just bare bones in it.
What time did you go to bed? You slept all day.
Oh, we don't want to talk about it.
What are we doing today?
What am I doing today?
Yeah.
Absolutely nothing.
Well, the now 30-year-old reality TV star, Corey, he joins us now via Zoom from Georgia in the US. It's lovely to see you, Corey.
It's good to see you all. Thank you for having me.
Our pleasure. Hey, you've lost a stack of weight, 125 kilos, thanks to diet, exercise and a vertical sleeve gastrectomy. There we go. Thank you. Big mouthful. Stops you from having big mouthfuls too. How did you actually pull it off?
So it was actually, I think for me, the most successful part of my weight loss is I went into it not holding myself to the number on the scale, which sounds counterproductive, but I think when you focus on that number and you let that be what decides your success or failure, it's not a good way to live life. For me, it might sound cheesy, but instead of focusing on what I was losing, I started focusing on what I was gaining, is the cheesiest thing in the world, but it's true. Like when this started, I could walk maybe from my apartment to my car, but I'd be out of breath. And this morning I went on a 5-mile walk and, or 5 miles, that's like, or 5 kilos, I think is what it is for y'all.
Yeah. I love it. Might be cheesy, yeah, but you know what? Yeah. It's probably the smartest thing you can do. Yeah. I think it's great. This is heartbreaking, Corey, in that you were mercilessly bullied at school. What was that period of your life like? I mean, what kind of things did a bully say to you?
During that period of my life, I think it got to me early on, like in primary school. Yeah. But as I got into secondary, high school, you almost adapt to it. And I think coming out was kind of a benefit of being bullied. People would call you every name in the book and they'd come up to you and they'd be like, I'll beat you up. And that's great. But when I turn around and I say, please, like they freak out, you know? So it's a total safe zone. But I think for me, bullying, it was definitely painful early on.
Yeah.
But after a while, I learned to adapt, and that's pretty much how I got my mouth today, which, as you've seen on this show, yeah.
You also came out as gay at the age of 13. How did you navigate that? That's a big thing to do at such a young age. Brave, too.
Yeah, coming out at 13, it was difficult. I luckily had a gay straight alliance at my school. And I mean, I was just a 13-year-old chunky gay boy in the south of Georgia. So I didn't have a lot of resources or places where I felt accepted. So when I came out, I had a GSA, which is kind of like the first spot, which is a gay straight alliance, where you go into this meeting with other classmates, allies, and they're totally accepting. They talk about gay issues. And like, I've always been gay. I used to do full Britney choreography and performances at the karaoke bar.
Love that.
Don't think it was a shock to anyone, but.
Corey, your dad was a big supporter of you, and you recently lost, and we're so sorry to hear that. I can imagine this has impacted you hugely.
Yeah, I think for me and my dad, he was one of the first people that showed me a healthy way of eating and losing weight. Him and his wife lost a ton of weight before I even went on this journey. And so about 3 months before he passed away, we met. And in one conversation, he told me everything that I would have ever needed to hear. And I know not many people get that. And it was so fortunate. But even though I went on this weight loss journey without him, he's been there every step of the way.
And you say as well that your weight loss journey has really made a few things a bit different in your life. Obviously, you can walk around, you can walk now, you can exercise, which is brilliant, but also it's changed the way you date. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes. So I used to, I've never had a problem finding a man, and that was one of the things when we were filming the show, is I told them I'll do a date before surgery, not after, because I don't want America to think that I need a man to find, or surgery to find a man. But I'm now at this weird in-between point where the people who were interested in me aren't anymore, but I'm also starting to attract people who wouldn't have been interested in me before. So it's like this weird kind of middle ground, but I'm here for it. If a person thinks that they can tame me, then by all means.
You know what I love as well? That you, yeah. Your comedy, that you're really, really funny and you're making all these jokes. Are you okay with people laughing along as well, Corey?
I am. I think okay. For me, I wanted to change. I wanted to change the dynamic of how people who are plus size and on weight loss shows were shown. I'm not the sad person who sits in their room and cry. I'm the person who goes out there and gets it. And so, when this all started, I wasn't a victim of my weight. I took it and I empowered it. And I can either go along the weight loss journey and be miserable, or I can be happy. And I wanted to choose to be happy and really show something different.
Corey, could I ask, what if you're somebody in your situation who does not have that mindset that you have? Have you any kind of experience of what that person may need?
I think it comes down to the ability to love yourself.
Yeah.
Losing weight isn't going to change the way you feel about yourself. Even when people were at a smaller size or they felt like they were at their goal weight, they still negatively talked about themselves. I think it has to change with how you view yourself. I love myself. I don't mean that in a narcissistic way, but I think I'm the shit. But
and you know what? We need more of that. That is a beautiful attitude, Corey. We love it.
It's a credit to your father, who is such an influential part in your life as well, to instill that in you and for you to believe it and to trust it. Good on you, Corey.
Bye, honey. We'll see you soon.